We are Israel United in Christ. We out here teaching our people, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and the Native American that's listed on this sign right here, that we are the children of Israel according to the Bible. Do you agree with that, sis?
I agree.
Okay, so let me ask you a question, sis. Do you believe in God?
I believe in a God.
Do you believe in a God?
Yeah.
Okay. So do you believe in the God of this Bible?
That's right.
Yeah, I believe in the God of that Bible. I still question the gender.
You still question the gender? The gender meaning what? Is God a man or a woman? So what would you think God is?
By the natural soul, I believe it's a woman.
You believe it's a woman?
Yeah.
Well, we've been approved out the Bible that according to the scripture, God is not a woman, sister.
So
it's in your Bible, it's in this Bible, it's in every Bible.
We can't be jurisdiction on heaven or on earth. Women don't have no say-so. We can't be
bound. No, women do have a say-so. Women do have a say-so. No. But we all was brought up in many different ways that was wrong. Why would he speak in parables?
Yeah, speak as man in general.
Because Christ spoke in parables.
He said, I'm
going to tell
you
man. Okay,
so what
he said, I'm going to tell you why he spoke in parables. Because when you read the scripture, when the disciples came to Christ and asked him, why do you speak it in parables? Why? Because it was prophets that was keeping the commandments that understood those parables. That's who you're looking at right now. Read.
Chapter 13 and verse 10. And the disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou unto them in parables?
Mm-hmm.
He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given.
So to them, so give me how you understand the knowledge. So it's Christ said, why are you speaking this a parable? Because there was a lot of people around that didn't understand that God said, understand the Bible.
Right.
Because when you're not keeping the commandments of God, it's like in a cold. Everything doesn't make sense to you. It doesn't make sense until you start keeping God's laws. Then he revealed more and more throughout the Bible to you. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 28, verse 9. Whom shall he teach knowledge? Mm-hmm. And whom shall he make to understand doctrine? Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast.
Read that again.
Whom shall he teach knowledge? And whom shall he make to understand doctrine?
So that's a question. The question was saying, whom shall he teach knowledge and to make to understand doctrine? Which doctrine is this Bible?
He's talking to all men.
Read.
The fear
commandments. Not that read about them or heard of them. No, but actually do. So that's an action word. That means you're not going to have no understanding about this Bible unless you actually doing the commandments, which takes action. You just can't say, oh, yeah, I heard about that commandment or I heard about that law, but not one day you wake up, you apply it to yourself, and you're making sure that you're doing it.
Right. All I'm asking is, why do we all have jurisdiction on earth as well as in heaven? This is what I'm saying. Men do not respect women. They're killing our children. Where is the men? Where are
okay,
they?
Okay, now I see where you're going, sis. I'm going to deal with that.
I'm speaking worldly. I'm spiritual. I believe that it is God.
Right.
But I'm questioning, why do you think women suffer so long and do so many things? And if you guys can send them like this, you guys can bring teaching to the youth. That's as well.
Okay, but since that was two different questions, the first one you said...
Tell you why I'm questioning it. I'm not
okay.
I'm questioning it for the simple fact that there you are questioning it.
Right.
I'm Sarah.
Okay.
I'm the mother for generations to come. I'm not Sarah of all generations. I'm the one to come.
Right, sis, but first we gotta
get an understanding where I can dictate.
Right.
And I can be not a false prophet to the youth.
Okay, sis, but first we gotta deal with the first question at hand, then we'll go along.
That's the question.
No, the first thing you said that you believe that the woman is God.
I didn't say I believe. I said I'm coming to believe that.
Okay.
Women have no jurisdiction as well as earth or in the Bible.
Listen, to, read that.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 3. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
Okay, so the head of every man is an order with God. Everybody has their order upon the earth. The jurisdiction that you recall it to, is God has set that jurisdiction in that order. So it said, read that again.
But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
The head of every man is Christ. So that meaning, for all the men, our head is Christ.
Right.
Read.
And the head of the woman is the man.
And the head of the woman is the man. So the man, what you were saying, we are the head, so we lead the woman like Christ lead the man.
But then we are your eyes and we are your ears. No one is listening or seeing what.
Sister, the Bible don't say all that. The Bible says Christ is the head. That means Christ give us order and we take out the orders that Christ do and we follow those orders. Then the man, he sets the order in the presentation for the woman, and that's what the woman supposed to do. But throughout our captivity and throughout our oppression, men don't know how to be men no more, and women don't know how to be women no more.
Right.
It's just not the man, it's the women as well.
Well, right. It's not just the woman, but
I ain't saying it's just the woman, but I say the man too.
You supposed to guide that.
Well, okay, we're going to get to that, sis.
Well, they're locking men up to make women decide.
Verse 8. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man.
You see what the Bible says? Read that again for the sister.
Verse 7. For a man indeed ought not to cover his head, for as much as he is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of the man. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man.
It say the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. Because sis, let me tell you something. Listen, no, let me tell you something.
Speaking of conception, man makes a difference of what the sex that the woman is.
The Bible say the woman carry the 1,000 hours. But that's you, that's your role that God has created. The man placed the seed into you to give life.
Exactly.
You cannot do that alone by yourself,
no,
sister.
You cannot.
Exactly. So
I'm not here to be a demon. I'm talking for the book. For the simple fact that these questions need to be answered for the youth. They need to be questioned for their way of saying. They're unconfused about.
Right, get mad.
They don't understand what.
Says kings and king first. We're going to show you what the Bible talks about that. That's what we are here to do. We are here on this corner right now to raise all these men that's driving past in the cars. This brother standing right here. We came out here to call the man and raise the man up to show him how to be man.
And as
we do that, the man will stand up on their foot and then they will show the woman how to be a woman according to God's laws, according to the Bible.
The book of 1 Kings, chapter 2, verse
silent, learn to silence.
You got Martha, you got Ruth, you got Sarah.
Right, and, you, and all those names that you...
They don't even mention them women in the Bible.
The Bible don't mention the women. Your Christian church might don't mention these women in the Bible, but we mention them all the time.
I'm just saying.
Read.
The book of 1 Timothy, chapter 2, verse 11. Let the woman learn in silence.
That's what the Bible says. Now a lot of our sisters hear this, and then they think like, oh, they bashing the women, or it's overpowering the women.
Exactly.
But that's not our word.
That's what I'm saying.
That's not, I didn't put that line in the Bible. Who didn't put that line in the Bible? He did. That's God's word.
When they don't step up to the word.
Read it again.
Let the women learn in silence.
God said, let the women learn in silence.
Let the women learn in silence.
With all subjection.
With all subjection. The man is bringing out the word. You not on your phone, on FaceTime, study talking over the prophets while we bringing out the word. That's not what all subjection is. But you said you believe in the Bible.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.